Long Beach City, California is the place to be tonight. It's time for the 2016 Ballislife All-American Game presented by Eastbay. This evening, 22 outstanding young athletes from all over the nation will compete in the 6th annual Ballislife All-American Basketball Game. Just yesterday, the players arrived in Southern California and have been preparing and practicing for tonight's event. Almost every athlete playing tonight is committed to a major college, and they have come from all corners of the country.
The line outside stretching from Long Beach all the way up the coast to Malibu for the 6th annual Ballislife All-American Game. Hello again, everybody. I'm Fred Salas alongside Ronnie Flores. Glad you can be with us. The Professor Paul Westfall chiming in just a few moments. And Ronnie, I got to tell you, I feel like I have died and gone to basketball superstar heaven. There is so much talent on the floor, I can hardly wait.
Yes, Fred, it's a great experience, great group of guys. They should end their high school career on a high note. We got 20 of the best players in the country. Only one is undecided. That's Marquis Bolden. He's decided between Duke and Kentucky. We also got Lonzo Ball and Miles Bridges, which is leading team future. And we got Marquis Bolden on Team Elite.
Talk about what the fans can expect to see from the high-caliber athletes that are about to take the hardwood.
Well, they're definitely going to get up and down the court. It should be high-scoring, close to triple digits, and when it gets close at the end, we should see great basketball trying to win the game.
Well, Blake Griffin, men like Stanley Johnson have all graced us with their presence in this game. What can these guys look forward to as they move next to the collegiate level and then beyond that to the NBA?
Yes, now in its sixth year, the Ballislife All-American Game has a great cast of players, and you can expect a lot of these guys to make immediate impacts on the D1 level at the high level, and a few will definitely probably go the one and done route.
Excitement moments away. Meanwhile, let's check in with the Professor Paul Westfall.
Thanks a lot, Fred. While time will tell if there's any LeBron James or Kevin Durant from this year's class, one thing cannot be argued. The 2016 class is as deeply talented as any we've seen in the last decade, including the much ballyhooed 2007 class that included the likes of Derrick Rose, Kevin Love, James Harden, and Blake Griffin, all of which, of course, top-level NBA stars. This group is supremely talented with sensational skill sets on display tonight. Now, you'll see a lot of highlight film material, but if the game is competitive in the second half, one thing that separates these All-Americans from a lot of other talented players is their competitive fire. And I think if the game is close at the end, I would expect them to forego the highlight stuff and try to win the game. But it should be great fun. Sit back and enjoy the stars of tomorrow before they head off in so many different directions to continue their basketball careers at the college level. Should be great fun. Fred, back to you.
Let's look at tonight's outstanding players from all over the country. Team Elite, tonight's home team in white, includes Auburn-bound Mustapha Heron, who led his high school to 3 consecutive state titles. J.J. Caldwell is a talented guard headed to Texas A&M. Texas-bound James Banks will man the paint for Team Elite tonight. Making his SoCal return is Vance Jackson, who spent his senior season at prolific prep in Sonoma County after starring at St. John Bosco. Coming off a sensational performance at the Nike Hoop Summit is Arizona-bound Terrence Ferguson. Like T-Ferg, Andrew Jones is from the Lone Star State and headed to the University of Texas. Cassius Winston led University of Detroit Jesuit to a historic season as it finished a perfect 28-0. Arizona's Gatorade Player of the Year is here tonight. His name is Mitch Lightfoot, and he's Kansas-bound. A big piece of UCLA's outstanding recruiting class is 6'9", EK Anibogu. And on the bench for Team Elite is Josh Giles, Anibogu's high school coach at Centennial of Corona. Team Future is tonight's away team in black uniforms. First up is Michigan State-bound Miles Bridges, who's had a sensational senior campaign. Rawle Alkins was Pango's camp co-MVP and won the Adidas Nations Championship. What will he do for an encore? Everyone wants to watch UCLA-bound Lonzo Ball of Chino Hills one last time. Will he surpass 10 assists to break the game's all-time record? Another state champion is Rainier Beach's Sam Cunliffe, who will head from the Pacific Northwest to Arizona State. The crowd's going to love Team Future's Troy Baxter. The wing headed to South Florida is a crowd-pleasing dunker, and there will be plenty of those tonight. Marquette-bound Markus Howard of Finlay Prep isn't very big, but he's a big shot taker and maker. BYU's recruiting class includes power forward Yoli Childs, Utah's Class 5A MVP from Bingham High. If Baxter doesn't throw down the dunk of the night, it may come from Tennessee-bound Quay Parker, the latest dunking sensation from the first state in flight, North Carolina. Joining Onigbogu and Ball in Westwood is TJ Leaf of Foothills Christian, arguably San Diego County's best since Bill Walton. Last but certainly not least is DeJuan Huell, Florida's Class 6A Player of the Year, who made the locals happy by choosing the Miami Hurricanes. And coaching team future is Steve Bate, who guided Chino Hills to the 2016 Mythical National Title. It's Team Elite taking on Team Future in the 6th annual Ballislife All-American, and it's the event's best collection of talent yet. We'll be right back with the opening tip-off from Long Beach City College, the Ballislife All-American game presented by Eastbay.
Back live, Long Beach, California, the moment we've all been waiting for, the tip-off for the 6th annual Ballislife All-American game from Long Beach City College, presented by Eastbay. Fred Salas, Ronnie Flores, Paul Westfall in the house, getting ready for some of the best basketball action you have ever seen at this level. Here's the rules of the game, 20-minute halves, nobody fouls out, 1-1 after 10 team fouls, and no double bonus until the final minute. And God willing, this one goes into overtime. Ronnie?
Yes, Fred, if there's overtime, there's a 4-minute overtime with one timeout. Obviously, in a normal high school federation game, it's an 8-minute quarter for 32 minutes. These guys are going to go for 40 minutes, sort of like a college rule.
TJ Leaf, Marquis Bolden at center court, set to tip off. And here we go, into the hands of Team Future, and the Black can throw it down to Miles Bridges.
From Rawle Alkins there on the quick feet, dunk number one. We're going to have a lot tonight, Brent.
From outside, Andrew Jones off the mark. Loose ball picked up by the big man inside, Ike Onigbogu. And get ready for that man. Onigbogu is going to be all over the floor tonight.
Going to UCLA with Lonzo Ball and TJ Leaf are also on the floor right now.
Alkins from outside, and
DeJuan Huell jumps over the first VIP row. Way to start the game, wakes up the crowd a little bit there.
Indeed, woke up that front row big time.
DeJuan Hill's headed through the University of Miami. He's only the fourth McDonald's All-American ever to go to Miami. He's having a great evening in terms of having fun and getting into this game. So we'll see what he brings tonight.
Team Elite donned in white. Team Future in black. Both teams with pinstripes. Nice feed inside. And Mustapha Heron, who's headed to Auburn, lays it up and in.
Sacred Heart, Connecticut. There's Miles Bridges on the three.
Back the other way, Elite now. On the left wing is Heron against Ball for three. Little short, and the rebound into the hands of DeJuan Huell, and he throws it away. Heron with the finish.
Very active there, Mustapha Heron. Getting into this game. Lonzo throws it away.
Heron with the pass up to Ferguson. And nearly threw it away, and indeed, that's the end result.
Not a lot of space here on the baselines and the out-of-bounds areas here at Long Beach City College, Fred. Something to watch just in case kids fly. We already saw DeJuan Huell fly over the first row.
Ferguson from way downtown into the hands of Ball.
Lonzo's always surveying the court, looking up.
Ferguson won the slam dunk championship. Andrew Jones with the strip back the other way. Jones trying to get it to Mustapha Heron. And a little tall.
Lonzo with the easy left hand 50-foot pass like it's nothing. That's not a very easy pass, and got into the front court.
Rawle Alkins back up to Lonzo Ball from way outside, off the hill and into the hands of TJ Lee. Feed inside, slam dunk by DeJuan Huell. Huell averaging 24 points a game his senior year, 14 rebounds. This is Jones double-teamed on the right wing. Here's Heron on the drive. Layup won't go down. Rebound up ahead to Alkins, and Alkins will finish with the left hand.
Rawle Alkins, word of God, originally from Brooklyn. Just two nights ago, he was MVP of the Capital Classic in Washington, D.C. Flew out here, made the great effort to partake in this sixth annual Ballislife All-American game.
Heron's jumper is good, and a nice slam dunk by Miles Bridges. Making it look easy.
That's all power, Fred. That's Miles Bridges' game. Tom Izzo's going to love him at Michigan State.
Indeed, Bridges averaged 24 points a game his senior year. Here's Heron on ball, and Heron wins that battle. Up ahead to Leaf. Two-handed jam for TJ Leaf, headed to UCLA. The Bruins got a good one with him, and back the other way. Onigbogu with a slam. You gotta be kidding me. Rawle Alkins, back-to-back-to-back slam dunks by both of these teams.
Rawle Alkins piling up the points early.
And no whistle. Mustapha Heron comes up short. Alkins with another slam dunk.
Beautiful one-hand tap assist by Lonzo Ball. All-time leading assist leader in the state of California.
Andrew Jones for three. Jones from behind the arc. Other side, Lonzo Ball with a putback. That's good. Off the Alkins miss.
And Alkins has 8 points. He was looking for 11 there, but Ball was there to clean it up.
Andrew Jones on the dribble. Dumps inside and blowing the layup was Marquise Bolden, and the putback is good. And a whistle underneath. As we get down inside 16 minutes. And one of the unique things about this game, Ronnie Flores, is the starters, anybody could have started this game, but we have a unique rotation. Now inside 16 minutes, we're going to take a break.
All right, let's get this party started. I'm with the National Player of the Year, Chino Hills point guard Lonzo Ball. And Lonzo, you had a magical season. You played a national schedule. You went undefeated. You won the national title. But maybe the best thing, you got to play with your brothers. Did you get a chance to reflect on that magic carpet ride so far?
Yeah, you know, a little bit. Obviously, playing with my brothers, it was great. And like you said, we had a magical season. That doesn't happen every year. And hopefully, they can keep taking it from here.
All right, now, a lot of pressure. You're going to UCLA. Expectations are quite high. What do you have to do yourself in order to be successful at the next level?
You know, just get stronger, you know, and bring that leadership to the game. Obviously, they need a point guard right now. I feel like I'm coming there and fill that role and get some wins.
All right, I view you as a chess master. You seem to play the game a couple of moves ahead of everybody else. Where did that basketball IQ get started?
You know, just my dad. Ever since a young age, he taught me to play like that, and ever since then, I've been running with it.
All right, a very special player indeed. Someone we'll be watching at a couple of levels from here on out. It's been a pleasure to watch Lonzo Ball play. Let's go back to Fred and Ronnie. Thanks.
Nice job, Paul. Sam Cunliffe starts off his first minute of play with a three-pointer. Jackson answers with a three of his own. Howard, Parker, Cunliffe, Baxter, and Childs on for Team Future. And Caldwell, Lightfoot, Jackson, Banks, and Winston on for Team Elite in the white. 1 point game. Cunliffe off the hill. Rebound into the hands of Yoli Childs. Nice rebound, laying it up and in is Quay Parker. Boy, this game right from the start is gangbusted right now.
Definitely. Players will want to go at it a little bit, show a little showmanship like they do at the All-Star game.
And a whistle. Vance Jackson trying to work his way down the lane. And he will go to the line to shoot a pair of free throws. So now my question, Ronnie Flores, is how are these players at the free throw line?
Vance is a very good shooter. Let's see if he can knock down these free throws here. And of course, we proverbial jinxed him on the play there. Vance is known for his outside shooting. Southern California native, he's from Los Angeles. He played his senior year at Prolific Prep in Napa.
Missed them both. Back the other way comes Sam Cunliffe on the dribble. Cunliffe
taking it the distance.
Sam Cumliffe's going to surprise people, I think, out here, just like he did in the dunk contest. Fred, he's very athletic.
Cumliffe headed to Arizona State, will be a Sun Devil. Turned over by Elite. Here comes Team Future. Vance Jackson comes up with a loose ball. The other way. Cassius Winston feeds inside and layup underneath by Mitch Lightfoot. He gets his first bucket all tonight. The other way, Troy Baxter with the finish.
A little bit of a floor imbalance there. We'll see if they balance it out on the next couple of possessions.
Future up by five. Early on, first quarter action here from Long Beach. And a rainbow by Vance Jackson, who averaged 18 points a game, gets another bucket. Markus Howard on the dribble, down the lane, throws up a teardrop and not going to go down. Childs was there trying to finish, couldn't do it. Lightfoot down underneath. Strip from behind, nicely done by Childs. Back the other way, Parker, alley-oop, won't go down.
Mustard off the hot dog a little there. But Troy Baxter wanted to finish that one just a little bit off on the pass.
So Baxter loses the handle. Back comes Elite, trailing by three. Cassius Winston, beautiful layup, making it look easy.
Straight down Baudre there. Not a lot of help defense in this right now, Fred.
Not a lot of defense at all. Here's Cumliffe on the drive. Left-handed layup, a little short. And rebound back the other way comes Vance Jackson. And Jackson knows how to finish a play.
Jackson has 7 points off the bench for his team so far.
Jackson, 6'8", headed to UConn. That shot put up by Markus Howard doesn't go down. And here's Jackson again for three. Putback is good. James Banks headed to Texas. Right place at the right time.
James Banks is a workhorse. He's a typical back-to-the-basket player. He played with a lot of other talented D1 prospects at La Lemire in LaPorte, Indiana.
Cumliffe
from the South.
Beg your pardon. Baseline jumper no good. Here's Caldwell. JJ. Alley-oop. Little short. Back the other way. And Caldwell is injured. And everybody wants in the action, and we got a player down, and finishing was Caldwell. Beg your pardon, Mustapha Heron is the man that's down. And Vance Jackson, I beg your pardon, is the man that is injured. We're going to step aside. A 3-point advantage for Team Elite. Long Beach City College, and we're off to a running start. Presented by Eastbay, Fred Salas, Ronnie Flores, Paul Westfall. And we have another change in our lineup now. Ferguson, Jones, E.K. Bolden, and Caldwell on the floor for Team Elite, who have the advantage. And Bridges, Alkins, Leaf, Huell, and Howard back on the floor. And rest assured, Vance Jackson was able to get up off the floor and go to the bench. And let's check in with Paul Westfall.
All right, I'm with Vance Jackson. Vance, you scared everybody there. What happened on that drive to the basket?
I don't even know. All I know is my hamstrings, I didn't hurt. It was like a little cramp.
All right, as long as it's a little cramp, because there's a lot of people in Connecticut a little bit concerned right now. Now, you're a West Coast guy, but you're following Daniel Hamilton, former Bosco teammate, over to Connecticut. What made that the school of choice?
Coach Ali, he's like a dad, so I felt comfortable with the coach. And we have a good relationship, and I just feel like it was home.
Now, what is there anything specific you can tell me about? Because a lot of people say great things about Coach Ali. What do you like about him?
He's a coach's player. He makes sure everything's okay, and he can work out with us. Like, he just do the little things that some coaches can't do.
Nice. Now, at the next level, what do you got to do in order to get ready for the rigors of playing at a big-time program with big-time expectations?
It's just basketball, you know. It's something I love to do. And as long as you practice and make sure your game's tight, everything will come to you.
All right. Well, you know, we'll be watching. We've been watching you play out here on the West Coast for a long time. Best of luck in the future. Good choice in Connecticut, and good health all the way along. Thanks, fans.
Thank you.
Team Future trailing by 12. Miles Bridges from NBA range. Bang! From way outside.
That was about 35 feet there, Fred. And Miles Bridges is showing the complete package a little bit. Now he wants to go at T. Ferg, so they're going to go back and forth. Terrence Ferguson and Miles Bridges. Miles Bridges way off on that. I'm sorry, Terrence Ferguson.
T. Ferguson not close on the three-point attempt. And back, Bridges, air ball. Inbound to Team Future, they throw it away. Here comes Heron, one-on-one against Alkins, and the follow-up is good. Andrew Jones following the play, and he throws it down, headed to Texas and averaging 31 points a game. Back the other way goes Alkins off the glass.
Rawle Alkins, Mustapha Heron going at it.
Alley-oop and a foul. Rawle Alkins out of Raleigh, North Carolina.
Mustapha Heron and Rawle Alkins both have 10 points apiece right now.
EK Onigbogu at the line, average 19 points per game. Senior year goes 1-for-2 at the line. And back the other way comes TJ Leaf, pulls up for three, not close.
Andrew Jones got him with the okey-doke, throws it away there. Took the ball out of bounds off the back of the other opposing team's player.
TJ Leaf into the hands of Alkins. Alkins headed to Arizona. On the dribble, pulls up for three, a little long. Andrew Jones with a rebound. Jones dumps it off, and off the glass goes T. Ferguson. Nice alley-oop, and T.J. Leaf headed to UCLA with the finish. The slam dunk. Mustapha Heron, that was inside the arc, and throwing it down is Onigbogu. Onigbogu, the 6'9 power forward, headed to UCLA and laying it up and in now. DeJuan Huell, who averaged 24 points a game his senior year.
And DeJuan Huell played at Norland High School. He played for Team Breakdown AAU. Great player there in the state of Florida.
On the dribble, Andrew Jones against Miles Bridges. Jones off the mark, out ahead to Bridges. Throws it down off the glass. Signature move for Miles Bridges. And a nice play.
Okay, all right. Yeah.
Inside, Heron can't finish. Out ahead to Huell throwing it down. How many slam dunks have we seen here in the first half?
At least a dozen, Fred. DeJuan Huell's getting in there, getting the action, and he's smart enough to leak out a little bit. And look at him, he's handling the ball again. Nice pass. He might get it back here.
Good defense. Howard inside to Bridges, who throws it away off the rim. Leaf on the charge. He throws it down. TJ Leaf. And the Bruins getting a good one. The 6'9 power forward out of El Cajon, California.
3,000 point scorers, scored over 3,000 career points at Foothills Christian.
Count the basket as Mustapha Heron makes a nice move and gets to the hole. And he'll go to the line to shoot a free throw. We're going to step aside. 44-41, 3-point advantage for Team Future. Back after this.
I'm with one of the most fundamentally sound players I have ever seen, and that is TJ Leaf out of the San Diego section. TJ, you could have gone anywhere. UCLA, what made the difference?
I think Coach Alford made the difference in the end. I mean, Me and him built a very strong relationship, and it's just continuing to build, and I'm really excited to get in there.
Now, your dad was an All-American at Evansville, your brother's all-time San Diego section leading scorer. Coming from a hoop family, is that what built that strong fundamental base you've got?
I definitely think, I mean, growing up with my brother and my dad, they taught me everything I know. So growing up with them, I just learned from a young age, and I just got a lot better at a rapid rate, and I'm just blessed to be here.
Well, you are indeed a special player, but now at the next level, it gets a little tougher. What do you have to work on here before things get going up in Westwood in order to contribute right away?
I mean, everything. No one's there yet. I mean, not even the best players in the world are there yet. So I need to work on everything, getting stronger, getting more consistent with my jump shot, just with my game. I need to get better in every area, and I'm looking forward to doing that.
All right, I'm going to ask you a silly one now. Your dad was an All-American. Your brother was a terrific player. But if you played the Ball family three-on-three, who would win?
I mean, come on now. You know I got to say the Leafs.
I mean, that. Outstanding answer. TJ, best of luck. It's been a thrill watching you play for all these years. Good luck up in Westwood.
Thank you, sir. I appreciate it.
TJ Leaf. Great to see a humble player, albeit he did pick the Leafs over the Balls. But all is well with TJ Leaf, and he is UCLA bound. And that free throw put up by Mustapha Heron is good. That finishes his effort here through the first. 8 minutes of play. He'll have a seat.
Yeah,
got a fresh set of 10 men back on the floor. And right now, Team Future trying to get it inside. And Cunliffe missed everything. Pass advance out in front to Winston. And Leaf. Check that, Lightfoot trying to finish. And a whistle. Starting five on the floor for Team Elite. Lightfoot, Jackson, Banks, Winston, Heron. For Team Future, Parker, Cunliffe, Baxter, Childs, and Lonzo Ball now. Inside, Ball throws it in. Puts it in the hands of Yoli Childs, and it's knocked out of play.
Team Elite is in the white uniforms. And Team Future is in the black, just in case you're logging in now.
Alley-oop to Quay Parker, who finishes with authority.
That's what Quay Parker does good. Headed to Tennessee's YouTube dunker sensation.
Spin move. Nice touch by J.J. Caldwell. Headed to Texas A&M. Parker now pulls up for three. That one won't go down. Rebound into the hands of James Banks, and up ahead to Vance Jackson. Good to see him back on his feet after suffering a slight injury. And how critical are these injuries in these All-Star games? You don't want to ruin a college career by going down in a game like this.
Of course not, Fred. You know, their players are wary of that. They either go really hard or they don't want to play. They don't like to horse around in practice. They either go really hard or they don't practice. And the last couple practices, the last few days here, in Long Beach, there's a little bit of that.
Caldwell finished on the other end, and Lonzo Ball on this end. Lightfoot, nothing. Ball quickly ahead to Parker. Reverse slam dunk. 48-48. Did you expect anything less than this? Winston on the drive. Baseline layup is good.
These teams are very even, Fred. Great All-Americans on both sides, so you expect a close game.
Three-point hit. Sam Cunliffe. Cunliffe off of Renee Beach. Seattle, and a slam dunk by James Banks. Throwing it down, Lonzo Ball in the alley-oop. Lightfoot needs a bounce, doesn't get it. Jackson with the finish.
Vance Jackson having himself a nice game off the bench here. Vance was very...
Beg your pardon, Roddy.
Lance was very into playing good at this game. You know, back home he had a lot of incentive. A lot of family from Pasadena and Los Angeles here to watch Vance play tonight.
Ball trying to get it to Parker on that last attempt. Back the other way comes Cassius Winston. Winston headed to Michigan State, tied up and taken away, and a whistle. So Winston bailed out as Yoli Childs stole the ball. Reggie Ramirez, one of our three officials, with the whistle. Lightfoot with the alley-oop, and count the basket. So Mitch Lightfoot out of Gilbert Christian in Arizona headed to Kansas. 6'9 power forward will go to the line to try and make it a three-point play.
And Fred, you talked a little bit about getting hurt and playing hard. Mitch Lightfoot set the tone in practice this week. He was one of the players in the front court that was really practicing hard, getting the front court players to work hard. The back court players kind of took it a little more easy, but the front court players were really working in the two practices.
Cunliffe outside the arc on the right side. Cunliffe, that's a two-pointer, won't go down. And a few players standing around looking except for Jackson, and he throws it away to Lonzo Ball. Puts it ahead to Baxter with the finish. Troy Baxter headed to South Florida.
And that's Lonzo Ball's sixth assist in this game. The record is 10, held by Tyler Uli. 10 assists in the game. Lonzo Ball's already halfway to that point. See if he gets the assist record. He tied the assist record at the McDonald's All-American game of Jock Vaughn of 13.
Jackson to NBA range, no good. Lonzo Ball hustling, alley-oop, finished by Cunliffe. Amazing finish by the big man. Baseline jumper goes down, gets a bounce. That was Winston. Ball with a quick pass to the front court to Parker. Parker pulls up and not close. Into the hands of Child, who throws it up in the paint. And a whistle. We now have 3:55 left in the first half. We're going to step aside. An outstanding game. You're watching the 6th annual Ball is Life All-American game presented by Eastbay.
I'm with Marquise Bolden, the last of the undecided players. Now, you're trying to decide between Duke and Kentucky, which is like trying to pick between a Ferrari and a Maserati. I'm not asking you for a decision, but are you close?
Yeah, I'm definitely close. I mean, I'm making that decision real soon.
Now, what are some of the factors that are going into the what is probably the biggest decision that you've made up to this point in your life?
Really just the relationships I have with the coaches and how comfortable I feel in that university.
Now, in an age where a lot of bigs want to face up and shoot threes, you're kind of a throwback. You want to play with your back to the basket down low. Where did that mentality come from? When did you decide, I'm going old school here?
Really just realizing what type of body I had and what I could do. I mean, I'm not trying to, you know, go out here and do something that I can't or that I'm not able to do. So, I mean, I just play to my strength and do what I do.
Well, whomever you decide suddenly becomes right to the forefront of the recruiting class of 2016. Best of luck, young man, with your choice. You can't go wrong either way, but you know we'll be watching. Thanks for the time.
Thank you.
Bolden is 6'10 center, yet undecided. Kentucky, Duke, your thoughts, Ronnie?
Well, some people thought he was going to announce on his birthday, which was April 17th, and he kind of scaled back on that. And I asked him this week, is he ready? And he said he's not ready to make that decision just yet. So he's kind of keep the tight lip there.
Three-point attempt by Andrew Jones hits. And Jones averaged 31 points a game his senior season. And we've got a fresh set of 10 on the floor right now. On the dribble is Howard. And Howard not able to convert. Back the other way goes Caldwell. Throwing it down. Following the play was Andrew Jones again. Lightfoot on the floor, Jackson, Banks, Watson, Caldwell and Jones, and now Aikens, Lee, Fuel, Howard, and Parker on the floor. Three-point attempt doesn't go down. Rejection of the paint. Beautiful defense by Team Future. Alley-oop, and the finish by Duane Fuel.
Jones with the ball. Oh, yeah, Jones. Let me see the handle on that. Oh. Uses the screen, doesn't see it,
got to
finish.
Oh,
not bad.
Nice job along the baseline. EK Onigbogu. Onigbogu out of Centennial High School, Corona, California. On the dribble is Parker. Beats it ahead to TJ Leaf, who throws it down.
That's his 8th point tonight. TJ Leaf has 8 points and 4 rebounds.
Jones off the mark with that pass attempt, and back the other way comes Alkins.
Nobody wants to step up, crossover. Oh, it's a spin. Oh, give it up.
Alkins
ran into a brick wall there.
Indeed he did, and he throws it away ahead to Caldwell, who throws it ahead to Jones. Make it Mustapha Heron with the two-handed jam. No look inside and rejected down low by James Banks. Trying to convert was Alkins off the Markus Howard pass.
And on the other end for the white team, Team Elite, Heron has 15 points after that breakaway layup.
Alkins at the line. First one rims out. There you see the numbers on Alkins.
He was actually the Pangos camp co-MVP with Mustapha Heron. Rawle Alkins and Mustapha Heron, good friends and competitors off on the court and good friends off of it.
Jones on the dribble, throws it up on a Gogu. Now Heron, left-hand layup is short. Leaf the other way. And with the left hand, Rawle Alkins, averaged 23 points a game his senior year. He throws that one down.
From the team perspective, word of God didn't have the season they wanted to, but Rawle Alkins really wants to show himself as one of the top players in the country on the postseason All-Star circuit. Word of God was supposed to be nationally ranked during the season, but they didn't have the season they were quite expected to.
And on the dribble, Howard lost it out of play. J.J. Caldwell converted his last field goal attempt a moment ago. Inbounds, and he'll bring it out of the backcourt. So we approach the final minute here in the first half. 70-66. Needs a bounce, doesn't go down. Caldwell from the right side. Rebound into the hands of Alkins. Quickly ahead to Parker, and Parker lost the handle. Here's Andrew Jones. The rainbow. And off the right side of the rim. Back ahead to Huell. Huell's can't get it to go down, and TJ Leaf. Not only does he convert, but he gets a steal and nearly converts a reverse layup. Nice effort. Mustapha Heron, blue collar labor here in the late stages of the first half. Loose ball, JJ Caldwell. Little overpassing in this All-Star game and needs a bounce, doesn't get it. Andrew Jones was at the rim and couldn't convert. Alkins for three at the buzzer. Rawle Alkins headed to Arizona, averaging 23 points a game. And boy, what a hot hand and a way to finish. And they take the lead away from Team Elite. So Team Future with that final three-point bucket, Ronnie. Able to take the lead in a wild first half, 143 points in the first half, and these boys are in high school.
Yes, Rawle Alkins has 16 points on that three, on that late one, gave him the lead. So,
and let's check in with Paul Westfall, standing by with Markus Howard.
All right, Markus, you're from Arizona. You played a year at Las Vegas. You're going to Marquette. Have you ever been in the snow?
No, I haven't.
Well, what made Marquette the school of choice?
I just had a real good relationship with the coaching staff. Nice, got a great feel for the school as well.
Well, now you're a terrific student. You graduated in 3 years with honors. How do you transfer that academic excellence to the basketball court?
I mean, just having good study habits and make sure it translates to college. So just keep doing the things I'm doing, which is always studying, making sure I get my work done.
Now, you're a point guard that can really score. Do you have a preference at the next level?
No, I'm going to do whatever the coaches need me to do, so I'm just really excited to get up there and contribute.
All right, you're playing with a friend of mine, Caden Reinhardt.
Yes,
can you make sure Caden gets enough shots?
Yes, sir, I can.
All right, Markus, best of luck up there at Marquette. Steve Wojciechowski is the coach. They call him Wojo. He's got the mojo working in Milwaukee. Marquette's going to be good. Thank you, Markus.
Some great action here in the 6th annual Ballislife All-American Game presented by Eastbay from Long Beach City College. Glad you're watching. Fred Salas, Ronnie Flores, Paul Westfall. We're at halftime and an exciting matchup and the future ahead of Elite by one, 72-71. Stay tuned for more basketball action right after this. Back live, Long Beach, California. Ronnie, your thoughts on the first half? 143 points amongst the best of the best. That is just an outstanding effort and a lot of offensive production.
Yes, Fred, we have a close game here. Team Future is down by a point, and White Team, Team Elite is up 72-71. Some leading scorers, we have Andrew Jones with the White Team with 10 points, Cassius Winston with 6 points, Lonzo Ball has 6 points, 4 rebounds, and 7 assists. TJ Leaf with 10.6 rebounds. And here you look at the game record, Stanley Johnson, 39 points in the 2014 game. Jordan Bell had 16 rebounds in the 2013 game for the all-time record. Scott Labassiere, just last year, the MVP with Thon Maker, 15 rebounds. And if you look at Jordan Bell, you look at a player, you say, what translates to the next level? Rebounding and defense always translate. Jordan Bell, even doesn't matter of his size, he had 16 rebounds in this game, and he's doing the same thing at the University of Oregon. You know, we look at that, that always translates regardless of his size. He's only about 6'6", 6'7", and he also has the game record for, in this Ballislife All-American game, with 3 blocked shots. So when you look at that, you see, wow, you know, that is always a translatable skill on the basketball court, rebounding and shot blocking. And just here we go to high school, and we look at Jordan Bell there with 3 blocked shots, and we go to the assists. Dominique Artis, who had a great game in 2012. 10 assists along with Tyler Uli for the all-time record. And Lonzo Ball, like I said, has 7 assists here in the first half. He has a chance to break this record tonight. He has 6 points, 4 rebounds, and 7 assists in one half of play, Fred.
I've got a feeling that record is going to go to Lonzo Ball before the final clock ticks off.
And here's the all-time game MVPs. We talk about MVPs. We go with Rawle Alkins had 16 points at the half, and Mustapha Heron 17 points. So they might be in the running for that MVP, and we look at the past MVPs. Like I said, last year, Thon Maker, Sky Labassiere. 2 years ago, Stanley Johnson and Shaquan Aaron. Even though Tyler Uli had a great game, Jordan Bell was the MVP. Gabe York, who went on to play at the University of Arizona. Princey Biff, a big-time shot blocker, who had a great game. And in the first inaugural game in 2011, Amir Garrett, who is now a big-time left-handed southpaw pitcher in the Cincinnati Reds organization. So across the board, a lot of great players in the first 5 years, Fred.
Yeah, we had a chance to catch up with Stanley Johnson earlier tonight. He's in the house. Detroit Piston, which gives you an idea for the fans that aren't familiar with this format and the Ballislife athlete. These guys go on to the next level, not only collegiate, but the ultimate level, the NBA. We're going to take a break. Step aside. We're at halftime, 72-71. Back after this.
We're at halftime, and I'm with Michigan's Mr. Basketball, Cassius Winston. And Cassius, can you describe the ride that your team, University of Detroit Jesuit High School, you won the first state championship in school history. What was that like?
I mean, it was an amazing feeling. Nothing, you know, it was the first time to ever do it. First school, first time in school history, so it was an amazing feeling.
Now, you're going to Michigan State. Was there ever any doubt that you were going to be a Spartan?
I mean, I had a lot of good schools recruiting me, so I really did go through all my options and weigh them out, but at the end of the day, Michigan State was the best option.
Now, you're being joined by a tremendous recruiting class, including a good friend of yours, Miles Bridges. You guys are so close. How did the Michigan State alums, how did they fare in getting you guys all to go to Michigan State?
They definitely showed that Michigan State is a family, and that's important to both of us. They come back, they show love, and all those things we look forward to.
Now, and I mean this with the most ultimate compliments, you're an old school point guard. I mean, you want to pass first, you play the game the right way. When did that mentality begin for you as a player?
When I start playing with a lot of other talented guys, I figured that, I mean, I'm not going to be the scorer on the team, so I'm going to get everybody in a position where they can score the basketball.
All right. Well, Big Ten basketball, it's a little rugged. It's a little different. What do you got to work on before you start Spartan basketball?
Like I said, definitely got to work on my strength and my conditioning and things like that. Got to be able to defend better. And after that, I'll be okay.
We look forward to watching you play. You are a special talent. And Michigan State had a tremendous recruiting class. And the Spartans are going to be right back up at the top where they always seem to be. Thanks for the time, Cassius.
Thank you.
All right, we're Winston at halftime here in Long Beach. This is the Ballislife All-American game presented by Eastbay. We'll be back with a special halftime show and some first half highlights when we come back.
are live back here, the sixth annual Ballislife All-American Game presented by Eastbay from Long Beach City College, Long Beach, California. Fred Salas, Ronnie Flores, Paul Westfall, thank you for joining us. An exciting first half. We are moments away from second half action. A one-point advantage for the home team, Elite over Team Future. Let's take a look at most points in career. Take it away, Ronnie.
TJ Leaf and his brother Troy Leaf, who just took a job at the Masters College. Two brothers in the top seven all-time state California scorers, over 3,000 career points. And you see TJ Leaf actually went over 3,000. He had a huge game against Chino Hills and Lonzo Ball, a game that they lost. He had 44 points, and that got him over the 3,000 mark. And, you know, he's unofficially the Mr. Basketball in the state of California. And in most years, he would be easily the Mr. Basketball. Just Lonzo Ball had that great of a year. And the team success of Chino Hills also made a big difference.
Well, no one other than Bill Walton, his only competition coming out of San Diego County, all time that is. And doing a solid job in this one. And he's got a bright future, does TJ Leaf, headed to UCLA, and again, the Bruins getting a good one.
Correct, and you're also getting all-time assist leader Lonzo Ball. Became the state's all-time assist leader this season, passing Khalib Hatcher, passing Jason Kidd, passing Jock Vaughn. Interesting that they're both going to UCLA, and Lonzo Ball, you look back, and I knew right away, I told Coach Bake when he was going into a sophomore year, let's start keeping track of his numbers. He started keeping track of his assists and his steals. And he was able to take that and also make that team success. Even though he had the individual marks there as an all-time state assist leader, he did that in the context of winning, which is even more impressive, Fred. And you see he's the state's all-time assist leader. He's having a great time. He has 7 assists in this game in the first half, 6 points, 4 rebounds. TJ Leaf has 10 points and 6 rebounds. So the UCLA connection, along with EK Enigabu, doing a great job for the Black team.
Well, the Black team made up Team Future. Steve Bake, head coach Chino Hills, 6 years there, and he brought a 2016 national title to Chino Hills High School. For Team Elite, Josh Giles out of Corona Centennial. They made it all the way to the state, losing to St. Augustine. And Team Elite, Don in white, Mustapha Heron, J.J. Caldwell, Vance Jackson, Terrence Ferguson, T-Ferg, as he is commonly referred to, James Bank, Andrew Jones, Cassius Winston, Marquise Bolden, EK Onigogu, out of Centennial High School, Mitch Lightfoot, rounding out Team Elite. For Team Future, Miles Bridges, Rawle Alkins, Lonzo Ball, Sam Cunliffe in your picture there, Troy Baxter, Markus Howard, Yoli Childs, Quay Parker, TJ Leaf, and DeJuan Huell. And starting in the second half will be, for Team Elite, Jackson, Banks, Winston, Heron, and Ferguson. And for Team Future, Cunliffe, Baxter, Childs, Ball, and Banks. So we are set for second half action. 143 points scored in the first half. Then Ronnie, that's a lot of points.
Cassius Winston in the front court. Close game, hopefully he'll stay close the rest of the way.
Well, I'm hoping for overtime. On the dribble is Vance Jackson. Cunliffe defending. That one off the mark. Back the other way, and Miles Bridges blows the reverse slam dunk. And Alonzo Ball, his brothers are here, LeAngelo and LaMelo, the freshmen. You think they're kind of itching across the court from us to get in this game?
Oh, you know they wish they could play with their brother tonight. Two key cogs on that Chino Hills National Championship team.
Miles Bridges throws it down off the Lonzo Ball. assist off the glass and ball applying pressure in the backcourt.
Andrew Jones taking it all the way, misses it.
Here's ball again. To Bridges, blows the layup.
And blue assist number 9. Lonzo has 8 assists already.
Back the other way, Mustapha Heron with the finish.
19 points for Mustapha Heron so far.
Bridges, alley-oop to Lonzo Ball, who throws it down. Andrew Jones down the lane, getting to the hands of Heron, who drops it in.
Mustapha's a bucket getter.
Bridges to Cunliffe, back to Bridges. Bridges defended nicely by Banks in the paint, and here comes Heron. Mustapha Heron, a 360 slam dunk. Throwing it down is Troy Baxter.
A lot of high-flying dunks, but Mustapha Heron is racking up the points. Has 23 unofficially right now, Fred.
155 combined points amongst these All-Stars. And on the dribble is Winston. Blows the layup. Putback is blown as well. And coming away with it was Yoli Childs. This is Cunliffe. Alley-oop to Miles Bridges. Team Future with a 1-point advantage. Three-pointer by Jones off the mark. Ball with the hustle. And the alley-oop, and throwing it down again is Miles Bridges. And this is just amazing action with these All-Stars. Camping out back there was Mustapha Heron with the slam.
Early line on the MVP, maybe Mustapha Heron, Lonzo Ball. They're going at it, but hopefully they pick up the intensity here on this line shift. Still a close game though, Fred.
Troy Baxter with the slam dunk. Ahead to Jones. And that caroms all the way back to the press box. I have a question for you. Are we going to see any defense in this game?
Maybe, Fred. Benches are kind of
intensified defense.
Yeah, they're itching to play a little bit, and they're hopefully we'll get on this line shift here a little bit more intensity.
Cunliffe from Ball, and he's working on double digits in the assist category and a steal. Bridges now trying to throw it down and running into some defense. Playing tough with Banks and Vance Jackson.
We saw James Banks in the first half. He blocked a couple shots. James Banks is an old school rim protector. He doesn't want to allow just easy points in the paint. He did that at La Lemire. Didn't score a lot.
Jones to James Banks with a reverse slam dunk.
It's only fitting to get the big man some points. He's working hard underneath.
Cunliffe across the timeline.
There he is again, altering that shot.
Childs off the miss. Loose ball picked up by Andrew Jones. Nobody home, and can't believe 4 players and no defenders, and they lost the ball. 16 minutes left in this 6th annual All-American game. We're going to step aside. Break time. Back with more action after this.
New York City has been legendary for great guards, and I'm standing one of the next great ones coming out of NYC, and that's Rawle Alkins. Rawle, you're an NYC guy. It had to be tough to decide between Arizona and St. John's. What made the difference for Tucson?
Really the winning factor. You know, Arizona is known for winning. I think they have about 1 loss in 5 years at home. So, you know, that's great to have that home court advantage. And, you know, I would always be a New Yorker. I would always rep New York no matter where I am. So, but I just have to do what's best for me.
All right. Now, you're known as an elite defender. A lot of guys with your talent focus on the offensive end of the game, but you really like to defend. When did that sort of become your calling card in basketball?
Just me being from New York, you know, you're always taught to be aggressive and be physical. So, you know, being from New York, you're aware of a lot more. If you leave your door open in North Carolina, where I'm at now, you don't have no worries. But if you go to New York, you have to, like, your car's gone.
All right, well, now Arizona, everybody's working on their game, but you're working on your game and maybe working on your body a little bit. Tell us about that.
I'm working on everything, man. I'm in the gym eight times a week. So, you know, I'm in the gym every night. I think there was some confusion. Everyone's saying I added about a bunch of bad weight on me. So, you know, ever since then, you know, I'm not saying I didn't listen to the media, but, you know, it's good to always just be sure. So I just went to the gym on my own. I started lifting a little bit and then, you know, running a lot more. And now I feel like I'm back to the old me.
Well, you look like Pac-12 caliber to me. Let me just point it to you, rather frankly. Now, on a little more serious note, your AAU team, the New York Rams, they started something to make a statement, and that's the orange patch. Tell everybody about what the orange patch means.
Yeah, it happened one time. A kid, he's actually in the gym right now. He got shot as a sophomore. He got shot in the chest just walking home from school. And, you know, they started this thing called No Gun Violence in, I forgot what's the name of it, but it's like a patch, the patch, that's what I'm talking about. So, you know, it made worldwide news, ESPN Sports Center, and they did a story on it. And, you know, it's not right. It's not right to have that gun violence, and that's part of living in New York. You know, nowhere, any other state, you don't have to worry about that.
Well, it's an admirable cause. Best of luck to you and the future down in Tucson. You know, we'll be watching. And the statement they're making against gun violence in New York is an absolutely a noble cause. And we're grateful for all of the efforts there for the New York Rams.
Nice job, Paul. Meanwhile, this game continues with TJ Leaf with a finish. Also, Ike Onigbogu. He got his started points here in the second half, and now throwing it down once again is Onigbogu. And Ike is on fire along with Bolden, Caldwell, Lightfoot, and Jackson. Also in there now is Leaf, Huell, Howard, Parker, and Cunliffe. And Cunliffe short on the three-point attempt. And here comes J.J. Caldwell. And blowing the layup was Mitch Lightfoot. And here comes Leaf. Inside 15 minutes left here in the second half. Kicking it out to a wide open Markus Howard. He's off the mark. Here goes Leaf. Dumps it off inside. Nice finish by Dewan Huell. And back comes Cassius Winston. Alley-oop. Hit the rim. And for the putback is Ike Onigbogu. And he's got 6 points here early on. Travel violation now by Markus Howard.
Markus Howard tried the move made famous by Skip to Malou. Back to the pass to himself. It just didn't work out. Ref called the travel.
So Team Future leading by one, 91-90. They've trailed most of the game, but not by more than 5 points. Here's Leaf. And they now lead by three, 93-90. Team Elite donned in white, Team Future in the black. Both teams with beautiful uniforms as Mitch Lightfoot with the two-handed jam.
Mitch Lightfoot's an old-school workhorse. He's trying to get his teammates fired up to play hard as he was during the practice sessions. Mitch Lightfoot, he's from Kansas, and he's going to play for the Jayhawks.
Lightfoot had to run and catch up with that one, and another slam dunk for the big man. 6'9", power forward going to Kansas out of Gilbert Christian in Arizona. Howard throws it off the glass and throws it away.
Mitch Lightfoot grew up a big Kansas City Chiefs fan, actually.
Caldwell throwing it down. Unselfish play by Cassius Winston. He'll get the assist. Back to a three-point game. And blowing the layup opportunity was Quay Parker. And back comes Caldwell. And nice touch by Mitch Lightfoot. Great action here. You're watching the sixth annual Ballislife All-American game. Long Beach City College pulling up is Huell, and that one off the mark. Approaching 12 minutes left in this superb game. Offensive prowess all the way around. And off the glass, another pretty shot. Cassius Winston this time. Huell with the unselfish play, gets it right back, and he's going to be fouled by J.J. Caldwell. And that'll send Duane Huell out of Miami, who's staying in Miami. 6'9 power forward to the line, and there you get a good look at head coach Steve Baik. 6 years at Chino Hills, a 2016 national title for Chino Hills. And a timeout on the floor, and his counterpart Josh Giles out of Corona Centennial in his 13th season. Both these head coaches honored to be here tonight.
And Fred, they actually played against each other in college. You see there, Coach Giles is a Concordia University two-time All-American, small college ball. These guys have a lot of friendly rivalry, and it's translating here tonight.
193, we'll step aside. Coming back with more after this.
I'm with Mitch Lightfoot. Mitch played high school basketball in Arizona, but he was born in Kansas City. So did you think you were dreaming when the phone rang and it was Coach Bill Self?
I mean, it was an awesome experience. Coach Self's a great person, and I was super excited to hear from him. And going to Kansas is a dream of mine, and I'm really excited for it.
No question about that. It's rare when you get a chance to live a dream, and we couldn't be happier for you for that. Now, for KU fans that maybe haven't seen you play, describe your skill set. How are you going to fit into the Jayhawk way of play?
For me, I like to work hard. I'm doing everything I can do for us to win. Taking charges, getting rebounds, scoring if they need me to score. With us losing Jamari and Perry, I mean, there's opportunity there. I just have to work my butt off and take advantage of that.
Yeah, definitely opportunity. KU's losing four bigs, and there's going to be some minutes available right away. What do you have to get better at? What are you working on so that you can contribute right away as a freshman?
I'm working on shooting and getting bigger. I'm lifting 6 days a week with my strength trainer, Coach Bouget, and really working my butt off trying to get better and being able to shoot the rock.
All right. Well, as I say, it's rare when you get a chance to live your dream. Congratulations to you and your family. Best of luck in the future. We'll be watching.
Thanks so much.
Ronnie, Mitch Lightfoot averaging 22 points a game his senior year, 11 rebounds a game. But what's most impressive is his shooting percentage, 65% field goal.
Definitely, Fred. He's a no-nonsense guy, knows what he is, plays back to the basket, and doesn't take any ill-advised outside shots that he can't make. Knows his game, and he's had a great week here, enjoying himself and also playing hard.
6'8", 210 pounds, class of 2016. Going to be a Jayhawk. And right now, Duane Huell at the line. He was fouled before the timeout. And he blows the layup. I beg your pardon, the free throw. That was a shooting foul. He'll pop it one more time. Huell 1-for-2 at the line, and he'll go to the bench now, and checking in will be Rawle Alkins out of Raleigh, North Carolina, 6'5", forward, headed to Arizona, averaging 23 points a game. Coming out of the backcourt, Mustapha Heron, quickly in the hands of Andrew Jones. Jones double team, ball playing a little defense, alley-oop, and overthrowing his intended target, Mustapha Heron.
Unofficially, Mustapha Heron's the leading scorer in this game with 25 points. Out of Sacred Heart in Waterbury, Connecticut, headed to Auburn. Led his team, high school team, to three consecutive state titles. Mustapha Heron, one of the best players in the country.
Alkins from way outside. And a whistle down low is the big man, Yoli Childs, out of Bingham. South Jordan, Utah, picks up the personal. Beg your pardon, we'll go to the line to shoot a pair of free throws. Childs averaged 18 points a game, 10 rebounds a game. And he's headed to BYU, 6'8 forward.
Yoli Childs' high school team lost a few games early that they didn't want to. They had a young team Yoli said, and then they figured it out and won the Utah State title.
Alley-oop and a nice touch and finish inside by James Banks. Banks headed to Texas and a turnover. Team Elite now taking a little bit of control here in the late stages of this second half. They lead by six. They have the ball, and on the dribble is Andrew Jones, who shoots an air ball. Ahead to Lonzo Ball. Unselfish play, and blowing the layup was James Banks. Beg your pardon, Troy Baxter.
That would have been Lonzo Ball's 12th assist. He already has the game record here, Paul. He has 8 points, 5 rebounds, 11 assists going into this line shift, and we'll see what kind of numbers he ends up with. He's in line for MVP, possibly with Mustapha Heron, Rawle Alkins. We'll see how the last 10-40 goes.
Rawle Alkins with the slam dunk off the glass, and that's answered by Andrew Jones. Here's Ball. And trying to throw it down was Miles Bridges. And it caroms off the rim, and back the other way comes Team Elite. This is Vance Jackson taking it coast to coast. Bridges to Ball, lays it up and in. Ball just seems like just an all-around great player, great temperament, and very cool, calm, and collected as James Banks gets another slam dunk. This is Baxter. Troy Baxter headed to South Florida.
Great player, great temperament, and very cool.
6-point game. Inside and finishing is Mustapha Heron. Alkins, this is Bridges now. Miles Bridges has his pocket pick, no warning. Taken away by Vance Jackson. Quickly ahead to Heron. Heron for three. Ball with a rebound. The follow-up goes in by Yoli Childs off the Baxter miss. Andrew Jones gets the roll. And the inbound pass kind of weak by Childs, and a three-point attempt won't go down. Put up by Vance Jackson. Alkins for three. That one rims out. Rebound into the hands of Banks.
Can't say enough about James Banks' work. He's actually one guy out here really working hard. Crowd's getting a little restless.
Mustapha Heron has extended the lead to double digits. Back to eight with a slam dunk by Childs. 220 points scored with 8.5 minutes left here in the ball game. And on the dribble, Cassius Winston. Andrew Jones for three. Pretty routine from behind the arc and inside the paint, and that inbound pass with 8 minutes left in the ball game will go out of play. And it's an 11-point advantage for Team Elite as we take a timeout. Exciting action here, the 6th annual Ballislife All-American Game from Long Beach City College. Fred Salas, Ronnie Flores, Paul Westphal in the house. Stay tuned, more action after this.
I'm with the highlight waiting to happen. It's Miles Bridges. Miles, you played at Huntington Prep in West Virginia, but you're from Flint, Michigan. Was there ever a doubt that you were not going to go back home and play for the Spartans?
In the summer, I was thinking about going to Kentucky because I talked to Coach Cal all the time through the summer, and I got to know him really well. But after my visit, when I got to know the coaching staff good, and I just felt like I was at home, so that's why I went to Michigan State.
Well, and Michigan State's awfully glad that you and that select class that is joining you did. Now, Michigan State's a family. I mean, I'm a Big Ten guy, and Michigan State, the alums, they really do support. I understand you've got a pretty good relationship with Draymond Green. Did he help in the process? What kind of advice do you get from Draymond?
Oh, no, he was just, even when I was a little fella, He was just giving me advice all the time. I knew him all my life, and he just knew I was going to be a good player, so he just gave me good advice, how to get through high school, how to handle adversity, and he's like a big brother to me.
Well, now, of course, as talented as you are, there's some things you got to work at. What are you working on before you get to East Lansing?
It's my ball handling, and my shot, my defense on guards, and my IQ.
Well, if you're going to play for Coach Izzo, you know you got to play D. We're delighted that you went. Just real quick, obviously there's a tragedy going on in your hometown with the water crisis. How has that impacted your life specifically?
Impacted my life a great deal because my mom, she's still there. My whole family's still there. And I'm just trying to do everything I can to donate money there whenever I can. Put something on Twitter for everybody to see it because, like, people didn't really know about it until this year. So that's what I'm trying to do.
Well, you represent very well, and I'm sure that Michigan State's delighted to have you. There is a website called helpourflint.com. If you want to go and check out that website, it'll tell you how you can help the good people of Flint, Michigan with that terrible drinking water tragedy. Miles, best of luck in the future.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Paul. Markus Howard hit a three-pointer, 121-109. Biggest lead of the game opened up now by Team Elite. They lead it by 12. Mitch Lightfoot from three-point range, and that one goes down. It gets a bounce. Lightfoot on the floor along with Bolden, Caldwell, Jackson, and Banks. And that man, Troy Baxter, with a slam dunk. Out on the floor with Cunliffe, Parker, Howard, and Huell. Now 6.5 minutes left in this one. Left-hander won't go down. Ball tips it out, nearly throws it away, and it is thrown away. A lot of turnovers here. Here's Andrew Jones to Lightfoot with the finish. Here's Ball headed to UCLA premier player. And another assist for Lonzo Ball. And Dewan Huell converts.
Unofficially, that's 13 assists for Lonzo Ball. Also headed toward a triple-double. He has about eight or nine rebounds right now. We'll get the official word on that in a few moments.
Mitch Lightfoot hits the jumper meanwhile. 22 points a game his senior year. And Marquise Bolden with the rebound. Outlet ahead to Vance Jackson. Jackson from NBA three-point range, and Lightfoot is there with the finish. Back comes Quay Parker. Lonzo Ball for a three. Is that his first three of the game? Unselfish play for Lonzo Ball. I'm not sure if he's hit one from behind the arc tonight, but he's contributing on all facets for his team. And meanwhile, J.J. Caldwell converts on the other end.
Markus Howard, three-point champion, misses on that long-range NBA one.
Here comes Andrew Jones. Alley-oop. To Caldwell, who throws it behind his back. No-look pass is picked up by Jackson.
Andrew Jones seems like he always has the ball in his hands trying to make something happen. He's from Midland, Texas. Grew up playing football, actually, in a great football town. Midland, Texas, known for football, but he switched over to basketball. He didn't like playing football in the cold, he said.
Vance Jackson picks up a rare personal foul. Again, nobody can foul out of this one. Lightfoot, another slam dunk. Markus Howard now, alley-oop, Lonzo Ball. Lonzo Ball, Bruins are getting a real special player with him. He is the all-around complete player. Andrew Jones on the dribble, left hand is going to be bailed out as he's fouled by Troy Baxter. And that'll send Jones to the line. Andrew Jones averaged 31 points a game with 10 rebounds a game and 7 assists a game. MacArthur High School, Irving, Texas. And 6'4 man is going to Texas University.
Andrew Jones had a unique situation. This year they were 22-7. They went to the state semifinals when he was a junior. He had to do more this year, and he said he took the leadership role, tried to do other things to help his team win. You see, he averaged 31-10-7, but they didn't have the record they did because they just didn't have much size.
And getting a good workout tonight, our game officials has thrown it down again as Marquise Bolden out of DeSoto, Texas. Zipper a chase, Vonda Anderson, our two female refs. as Bolden throws it down again. And Reggie Ramirez, our referee's in charge of this one. And count the basket. Great work going down the lane as we are now inside 4 minutes and a timeout on the floor. When we come back, we'll see a free throw. An attempt for a three-point conversion. It's a 20-point lead for Team Elite. Back after this.
They got it going on at Miami with Jim Larrañaga getting into the Sweet 16. I am with one of the commits to Miami, DeJuan Huell. DeJuan, we got to get you out there because you got to shoot a free throw. But when did you know you were going to stay home and go to Miami?
The day before the last day of the early signing period.
Now, Coach Larrañaga was quoted as saying he likes the way you defend. I don't hear that a lot about a lot of prep stars. What made that a priority in your game?
Well, if you'd be able to stop a defender, that's great. And all the coaches would love that. So
I
do that.
And then what ACC ball, quite a bit different than the prep game. What are you doing to get ready for ACC basketball?
Gaining weight, getting the weight room. We need to put on some muscles.
All right. Well, we'll be watching. You've got a great future ahead of you. Let's get you out there and shoot that free throw.
DeJuan Huell averaged 24 points a game to go along with 14 rebounds, as you heard. Paul Westphal, the 6'9 power forward staying in Miami. Back to live action inside the final 4 minutes, and from way outside goes Miles Bridges from downtown.
About a 40-footer there, Fred. That was a beautiful shot. He won't be shooting that for Tom Izzo, though.
That play, that is sick. Lightfoot off the rim. Rebound in the hands of Rawle Alkins. Lonzo Ball for three. That one's short. Rebound in the hands of Caldwell. Ahead to Heron. Mustapha Heron. Now a 19-point ball game. Alkins, NBA 3, won't go down. Loose ball picked up by Bridges. He shoots for three. That one's short. Rebound to the hands of Mustapha Heron. Ahead to Caldwell. Caldwell throws it back.
If we're going to have an MVP on the white team, it's going to be Mustapha Heron. He has 31 points right now, and he's looking for more on the baseline.
Heron pulls up, rims out, putback is good. Lightfoot has been all over the place. Here's Miles Bridges. Oh, and some defense coming by way of James Banks for Team Elite, and that will send Bridges to the line for a pair of free throws.
James Banks, again, taking the initiative to play defense, doesn't want to get his rim dunked on. So he gives him a little foul there, and Miles Bridges is going to the line.
Miles Bridges makes the first one count. Bridges out of Huntington Prep in West Virginia. Two for two here at the line. 6'7" forward headed to Michigan State. Caldwell kicks it out, air ball. Lightfoot again, how many does he have?
23 points in the second half, 28 overall for Mitch Lightfoot. The hard work he put during the week has paid off. Having an excellent game. Bill
Heron,
South's gonna love him.
Beg your pardon, Heron from Caldwell. And one of the things I'm taking away from this one, other than the talent that's on the floor, is the unselfish play. And not just here in this game, but all season. The senior year for all of these players. They are truly team guys. Bridges from Lonzo Ball, a reverse slam dunk. Bridges on Jones. Jones between the legs. Jones on the drive. Jones still with it, throws it up off the glass. Andrew Jones.
Andrew Jones promised me a good game today, and he's delivering. Picked up his intensity. Here he's going against Miles Bridges, one-on-one.
It's showtime here in Long Beach. Bridges, left-hand three-pointer, bang! And right now, DJ Head directing traffic. Our MC telling the players what to do, and they're following direction. Andrew Jones on Bridges. Needs a bounce, and he gets a tip from James Banks. Alonzo Ball. Beg your pardon, Lonzo Ball with the right hand. Inside the final minute. Heron. Three-pointer won't go down. Bridges with a rebound over the likes of Mitch Lightfoot.
That was a man's rebound, even though we're late in game here. Miles Bridges wants some more.
That's a three-pointer from NBA range. Won't go down. The tip doesn't go down either. Caldwell back the other way. To Lightfoot. Lightfoot now. Approaching 30. Rawle Alkins. And Alkins throws it down again. Final seconds of this one. Bridges now. Nobody on him. And that's it. The final, Team Elite 152. Team Future 134. 18-point victory for the home team, Team Elite, under head coach Josh Giles from Corona Centennial.
And we see the winning team, Mustapha Heron, is probably the MVP of this game. 31 points for the Sacred Heart Waterbury standout. On the other side, Lonzo Ball had a great game, broke the game's assist record, but his team took the loss. So great performance by both teams. Great way to end it, and great competition.
Ronnie, how many assists for Lonzo Ball? Reminding our fans that 10 was the record for assists in the All-American game.
He had 13 assists, 15 points, close to a triple-double here. We'll verify the last stats as we get ready to perform the MVPs.
Interesting for Lonzo Ball. He came into the game averaging 11 assists on the season his senior year to go along with 24 points and 11 rebounds. He had 11 on the season, 13 tonight for Mustapha Heron. He averaged 30 points per game. He cleans up with 31 tonight as you look at highlights from this sixth annual Ballislife All-American game. Presented by Eastbay, you've been watching the best of the best from Long Beach City College. And what a great night of basketball for everybody. At DOP Productions, our producer Dave Otta, our reporter Paul Westfall, coordinating producer and director Dakota Timmons, Diva Tamarani on graphics, our master camera Joseph Arellano, our cameraman Sergio Sanchez, and Tanner Schofield on the floor along with Paul Abizada. Bill Calhoun is our head audio man, our red hat was Mike Felix, and our grip Jacob Greenland. My name's Fred Salas, signing off for Ronnie Flores from Long Beach. Thanks for joining us. Good night, everybody.